Hi everyone. In today's video, we're going to talk about optionals within Java. You could basically think of an optional as a container object that may or may not contain a value. Right now, you might be thinking, why would I ever need that? In certain situations where, let's say, a method returns an object to you, you need to determine if it is non-null and then you can do something with it. There is much cleaner code you can do using optionals rather than the traditional null check, such as code right here. In this code, we have the findPerson method, which was returning a person object, and then we are checking to see if the person is null before we do something with it, and then we have to handle the else case if it is null. One of the major problems with code like this is you have to know that the findPerson method could return null. You have to look at the documentation, or you maybe have the source code in front of you. Let's say you were lazy and didn't do that. Well, now you've got a null pointer exception because you accessed something you shouldn't have. Instead, with an optional, the dilemma is put right in front of you, which basically says this may or may not contain a value. You need to make sure you check for that. If that distinction wasn't clear, don't worry. We'll go ahead and open up IntelliJ and look at some code examples. So to demonstrate what I was getting at, let's go ahead and create a person record with a name and an age. And then we will create a list of person. And we'll just call these people. And then we will create our people here. And now that we have our people list, I want to create a method called findPerson, which is going to take a name, let's say Ed, and then it's going to take in the people array. And now I need to create that method. It's going to return a person object. And then it will take the string name, and then it will take the person list. And now one way I could do it is I could say for person within people, if person.name.equals name, then I can return the person, otherwise return null. You'll see this kind of code quite often where you've got the nominal case where you found the entry you were looking for in the collection, otherwise you return null. So now up here, I have my person object, and you might think you could just do person.age, and then I could see what Ed's age is. And this should work in the nominal case. As expected, we get 25 here. But let's say that I put in a name like Tony, who isn't in the list, and I try it again. I get the very undesirable null pointer exception. So if I were to get around a null pointer exception, what you could do is you could say if person doesn't equal null, then I'd move this up, and I'd say otherwise, oops, and then I get the oops. So this does work, however, it's a lot of code. I have to explicitly call out null here, and then I have to do this null check. And now I need to document whoever is going to use findPerson that they need to do a null check on my data. Kind of gross. Now, there is a better way to do this with optionals. So instead of returning a person, I want to return an optional person. We have to import optional. And now what I need to do is this optional may or may not have a value. So in the case where it does have a value, then I can do optional.of person. And when it doesn't have a value, and I know it doesn't have a value, I can do optional.empty. You'll notice when I called optional here, there are three ways to make it optional. You can either use of empty or of nullable. So of is when you know that there's going to be a value. Empty is when you know there's not going to be a value, and of nullable is I don't know if this object is null or not, so go ahead and just handle that for me. So I could have replaced both of these calls with of nullable, but in the case I already knew what they were, I decided not to do that. And now up here, we need to make our return type an optional of a person. And now this person is no longer a person, it's really an optional person. So I'm going to go ahead and rename that just to make it clear that this optional may or may not have a value. And that's something important I should mention here. An optional itself should never be null. Instead, you should have an empty optional or an optional that has a value. If your optional is null, then you need to complain to whoever generated your method, because that optional should never be null from the method that returned it. And the main use case of an optional is as a return type to method. So complain to your API developer if you have a situation like that. Now, the next thing is most people who are newly introduced to optional, basically they take the same semantics of this code and they just replace it using optional methods. So I can do optional person dot is present. And now I know that the optional has a value. So I can do optional person dot get dot age, or I could have this oops here. This code will work, and I'll show that here. So is present is false because we had an empty because we didn't find the value and we print out oops. So that looks good. So what really is the benefit? If you still have to do this if else check and you're checking for is present rather than if you're dealing with a null reference? Well, there isn't a huge benefit in this particular case. And that's why I argue using the is present and get methods, while they are available, are ones you shouldn't really count on very much in your API when dealing with optionals. There are better ways to do it that I'll get into here in a second, but this is the way most people start with when they're working with optionals, and it works, but the main benefit you get is you get this optional return value, and you think in your code, okay, I need to check if a value is present, versus if you just get a regular object, you might bypass the null check. Okay, so this code is marginally better. Let's make it a good bit better. Let's think about what we can do with this optional. Well, one thing we can do is we can map it. So just like you would with a stream when you want to map a collection, we can also map an optional. So now what I want to do is I want to map this optional from the person into their age that they are corresponding to. So I can do person age. And now what this is going to do is it's going to say, if this optional has a value, now I'm going to return an optional corresponding with the method that we are calling here, which is the age method of person. So now I have an optional which may have an integer within it. And I'm going to do something that looks a little odd, and that is using the or else method. So basically, if the optional is empty, this is what I'm going to do now. I'm going to return an integer value of -1. And if I print this out, what's going to happen here is we're going to take the person that we started with, we're going to get their age if it is present, and if there's no value there, then we're going to return -1. And as expected, we return -1 here. Let's say that I change this to Martha, now I would expect a value. And we get a value of 39, as we would expect within our list of people. So that's pretty slick, huh? So we take the optional that we were originally given, we map it into something that we care about, and then we have a default value if something didn't work. Cool. So another useful method of optional is if present rather than is present. So I can say optional person dot if it's present, then I'm gonna go ahead and print it out. So in this case, since Martha is present, we get the printout of the record like we would expect. And then now if I just have a person that I know doesn't exist, then you see that we get no printout at all because if present checks for is present. So alternatively, let's say that I do want to do something if the value is not present. So I can do if present or else. And now this takes two parameters. The first one is the action if it is present. And I'm going to use the print line method reference here. And then now the second one is a runnable. And the runnable is what are we gonna do if the value is not present? So here I wanna print out oops. So I need to do a lambda expression and I'm gonna say system.out.println oops. If I run this, we get oops when there's nothing there. And then when we put something in there like Bob that we know is in the list, then we get the person printed out. One other thing you can do with an optional is you can throw an exception. Or else throw, meaning if the isPresent method returns false, we're going to throw an exception. If you hover over, the documentation says we're going to throw a no such element exception, which if you paid really close attention earlier, the get method looks pretty familiar, doesn't it? The get method does the same thing. It throws a no such element exception if no value is present. And looky here, the preferred alternative to this method is or else throw. So a bit of a funny story there. The get method is useful for those who are used to the semantics of null checks on object references, where they'll check if is present returns false, or if it returns true, then you can call get successfully. But really, the or else throw method clearly conveys if the optional does not have a value, we need to throw an exception. Now, that's not to say there aren't use cases for get. Just make sure you're careful when you're using it, that you're using it in a way that actually makes sense. In general, the rule of thumb I follow is if I'm doing too many if checks on whether an element is present, I'm probably doing something wrong, either with not using an optional or I'm not using the optional correctly. And lastly, just to put a bit of the icing on the cake, this method is already very easily doable using the Stream API that already returns optionals for us and everything. I can simplify this into people.stream.filter. Now for each person, I wanna check if person.name equals name, just like what we had in our if check earlier. And then I can say find any. And the find any method also returns an optional, look at that. So the Java 8 Stream API uses optionals, and you can incorporate them easily into your code when you're searching through a collection or other types of data structures. And that was an overview of using optionals within Java. If you enjoyed this video, please do smash that like button. I'd really appreciate it. Thank you for watching. I hope you have a good rest of your day, and I hope to see you next time. Take care.